again. He was on the Not Just Football podcast this week with Cam Hayward, where he played a game of either or. This just in.
Coaching Pittsburgh or Chicago.
That was it. Come on.
Ooh, not even close. All right, RC, why has Fields been able to find success with the Steelers offense?
I mean, he just said it. Arthur Smith. The best way to land a plane successfully is to have an amazing co-pilot. And yeah. You look at this relationship between Arthur Smith and Justin Fields, he's truly been listening and doing exactly what he was told. Think about week one. Justin Fields was told to keep the football out of the middle of the field, and he did that. The next week, keep the football away from Patrick Surtain and only make those throws when it's beneficial to us and George Pickens has those one-on-one matchups. He did that. This week, you move forward. He allowed him to use the opportunities in between the numbers and push the football in the intermediate level. He did those things, and he uses his legs not as a necessity, but when he can make sure it allows the team to be the best it can possibly be offensively. I think there's a level of trust between Arthur Smith and Justin Fields that he just didn't have in Chicago, and I believe that is breeding some confidence in the young quarterback.
Now, RC, this is another, like, game for the haters in a way, because for Pittsburgh and Justin to play well and beat Indy, he's going to have to do things that everyone says he can't do. Number one, because of their zone defense, you could just have to play really fast with your eyes. You got to make sure, because when you know this, where you're looking, people are going to. Number two, the timing's got to be fantastic, because once you decide I'm throwing football there, you got bodies driving. And then three, everyone says, well, Justin Fields can't work over the middle of the field. And that's the space where you wanted to kind of attack Indianapolis's cover three heavy zone defense. If he could do that the way he has the first three games, there's going to be another kind of checked box of I'm doing all the stuff that everyone says I can't do specifically against Indy's defense.
Right, but if you go back to Caleb Williams last week, think about the Jalen Jones interceptions that he threw. Both of those things were on the outskirts of the defense, and they were late. So if I'm Justin Fields, if I'm Arthur Smith, I'm preaching exactly what you just said, Dan. Get the football out of your hands, be decisive, but also understand that that defense is moving with your eyes. It's moving with your shoulders. And if all else fails, tuck the football, get what you can get, and let's line up for another play. Whether it's Freiermuth, George Pickens, Calvin Austin, or using the running backs in the pass game, I feel like Justin Fields has delegated the ball exactly where it needs to be, and I believe he takes another step in that against the zone defense of the Indianapolis Colts.
And guys, it's worth remembering that Fields has won 7 of his last 9 starts, dating back to week 12 of last season. Remember, he finished last season pretty strong. Really cool to see him have success.
A lot of catches in this league, man. I'm not worried about, you know, the catches and the yards and all of that. I have the most fun when I get the ball thrown my way. I mean, who doesn't?
Of course. Execution fuels emotion.
It has everything to do with execution, just making sure that we're doing whatever we can to win these football games, man. That's always going to be the goal.
All right, so Kelce's off to his worst start in his career. He has the fewest receptions, yards, touchdowns, first downs, and targets in the Chiefs' first three games of the season in his career. Mina, what's going on? Can Kelce shake off the rough start?
Oh, jeez.
Oh, no, I got it. I got it, Boogie. I got it. Travis Kelce. Yeah. Travis
My
Kelce.
Joke was so
Travis
good,
Kelce
though.
Is struggling. Travis Kelce is struggling. Like, man coverage sometimes getting held up at the line of scrimmage. I think a part of this, too, is it feels like Kansas City offense is out of whack. We know that him and Patrick Mahomes obviously have a sixth sense when the play is extending and they're trying to just create that backyard basketball semblance of an offense. But right now, they look like they're out of sync. Travis is not creating a lot of separation and working the zone. You expect it to get better throughout the season, but we've had conversations about Rishi Rice and a lot of other guys being the number one. So hopefully they'll get it figured out. We got a little bit of trust that they will, but as of right now, it doesn't look the same and it doesn't look as dominant as we've grown accustomed to.
Yeah, I mean, history tells you that maybe late in the season, things can get figured out. All right, let's go to the Bengals. And it's been a rough start in Cincinnati, right? Ja'Marr Chase hasn't quite gotten what he's wanted to get. I think we're going to see a tweet right here. Yeah, this from Ben Baby, our Bengals reporter. He said wide receiver Ja'Marr Chase on facing the Panthers with an 0-3 record, quote, we need this win 1,000%. So what do the numbers tell you? Well, it's been that Ja'Marr Chase is the lone bright spot, right? He's caught 16 of 18 targets. He's had four 20-yard catches and is averaging nearly 12 yards per target. The rest of the Cincy wideouts have 17 catches, and they're averaging 5.5 yards per target. Now we go to Mina. How did the Bengals get back on track this week?
Well, Laura, you hear me say wins are not a quarterback stat. Losses are not a wide receiver stat. And in this case, they have just about nothing to do with Ja'Marr Chase or even the rest of the wide receivers. Obviously, T. Higgins being back in the mix helps a great deal. The Bengals are losing because their defense has been really, really bad. And to that end, the offense has to be as explosive as they were against Washington for them to win any game, frankly. I don't care who's across the field from them. Andy Dalton played excellent last week. And there's a lot of pressure on this offense. Because of that, I do think having Higgins back, though, certainly helps in that regard in terms of easing some of the pressure on Chase and getting him more one-on-ones.
Let's go out to Pittsburgh, where Justin Fields set to start. All right, up next, the D in Dallas has been nowhere to be found. How does this defense get back on track? Swagger off against Jared Goff and the 2-1 Lions at 8 Eastern on ABC and ESPN Plus. Of course, Joe Buck, Troy Aikman, Lisa Salters on that one. I'll look at Danny Dimes. He's arriving there, getting ready for this game that's coming up in just a few hours. Thursday Night Football, Giants and Cowboys. Get you ready to go for that. Let's get Adam Schefter back in with us. Ready for tonight. CeeDee Lamb, Adam, was in the news for his sideline exchange with Dak Prescott last week. What's he saying about tonight's game?
Well, he apologized this week for the way that he acted last week. The team underperformed. CeeDee Lamb at the top of that list. And clearly, CeeDee Lamb is going to look tonight to make it up to the Dallas Cowboys and their fans with a big game against the New York Giants. We'll see if he can come through. The Giants are down a couple of cornerbacks. The matchup could be ripe, and CeeDee has essentially apologizing and payback on his mind tonight for the Dallas Cowboys. Meanwhile, the Daniel Jones Malik Nabers connection has been hot through the early part of the season, and this will be Malik Nabers' first NFL prime time game. We remember what Odell Beckham Jr. did early in his career against the Cowboys on primetime, a one-handed catch tonight. Malik Nabers gets to show everybody how good and dangerous he has been through the early part of the season, and he gets to do it against a Dallas defense that has really underwhelmed and underperformed so far. It has been lit up through the first three games. Defense has been under fire. Mike Zimmer, the defensive coordinator, has been questioned, and you know that they'll be looking to shut up all their critics and all the criticism that's come their way the last couple of weeks since they last won in Cleveland on opening day.
Yeah, let's live there for just a minute. Thanks to Adam. The Cowboys rushing defense has been the worst in literally the worst, okay? They rank last in yards per game, yards per rush, first downs allowed, and 10-yard rushes. Micah Parsons not happy with the performance so far this season.
You know, I feel like as a competitor, like, at some point, you got to be prideful enough to say, hey, I'm not going to allow this to happen.